see, weight distribution is pretty solid on your leg. Right? Most of the weight is on your pretty much heavy on the bottom, right? Then can you shift it so that you're going to be on the balls of your feet where you're a little bit more looser? And as opposed to having a wide
wouldn't move
shift,
as much like that, right?
What's
that? I wouldn't necessarily move as much like that, right?
Yes. And that's
be more fragile.
Well, not so much straight up. So if you think about a
prepared to count.
Yeah, well, here's a quick method to find a tie stance. You put your feet together. You have it at a 45-degree angle. You step forward. You step forward with the left foot. Now you feel that you're going to be off balance. So if I push you, what do you do with your other foot? You step out to the side, right? There it is. And then from that point, jump up 3 times. Get up on the toes. And there you go. There's more tie stance. Now, right over here, one thing that I see, okay? This shoulder should be lined up with that heel. So if I had a line, it's right behind you. So where do you think the weight is? The weight is back. So right over here. Up, a little bit up, right there, and then move forward for me.
Oh.
There you go, back. Okay, move to the side, move over there. Okay, there you go.
Good.
And then see, now you're going back to your snap, your wide. Yeah, and what I see automatically with your stance is that all I gotta do is get you
off the line.
Or, if I'm able to get an angle, I'm gonna take out this leg and that leg, or I basically just crush through. Or, when you see those guys that are moving, right? In reality, they're trying to take this leg and put it in that other leg, by boom, and that's how you fall on the ground. So if you have a proper stance, strike.
No one's ever kicked me in the leg and I fell on the ground, I'm just saying.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, but those guys are real high level tie boxes.
Relax, ladies,
right?
Please.
If you were to do tie boxing, that might pick you apart just because of your stance, because you're very heavy. And what do you think they're going to be doing? They're just going to be half this. Boom, right here. Boom, right over here.
Oh, perfect. Sit down and crunch, and the guys kick like that. That's why I do this, because it works for me.
For
most of the time.
Yeah, okay.
But then I only got 15 minutes when it counts.
Yes. And every time that the head up, so everywhere I try to tell the guys, if you're going high or you're looking straight up that clinch, any time that that head drops below your shoulder, guess what's coming? Boom, elbows, knees, you know, clinch. So that's why if you're going to be moving, keep your body on the toes. You see how easy was it for you to move in that stance? And then, do you think you can switch your stance when you're going to throw a big ball? Like, go back to your old stance so that you can throw those heavy hands?
Yeah.
So you can be right over here where you're working, right, for movement, when you're trapping somebody, using long-range weapons, and then when they get a little antsy, then you can switch your stance and then hit. Can you see that?
It's a transitional stance.
Yeah, but how many people can do that?
MMA has changed.